Monday Night Raw live tonight in Music City, USA, one of my favorite places in the whole world. Tootsie's Orchid Lounge right down here on Broadway, just across the street from where we are tonight, sold out in the Summit Center. But a party atmosphere on Broadway, but not a party atmosphere, I'm sure, in the locker room right now for one Shawn Michaels. We saw moments ago that we're just 55 days away from WrestleMania, and Shawn Michaels' appearance in that big event is in dire question.
Well, you're right, and I said it just seems like one disappointment after another for Shawn Michaels, and not just minor disappointments. I'm talking about major disappointments, and I don't know how much more he can take.
Would you say that it's perhaps the most disappointing 24-hour period in the career of Shawn Michaels?
Oh, without a doubt. I would say without a doubt.
First thing, congratulations on the match. Second, I'm really sorry about what happened last night. I can't speak for Cody, but man, I'm really sorry. I don't.
This is an Elimination Chamber qualifying match. Sit for one fall. Introducing the participants first, from Silsbee, Texas, weighing 418 pounds, is the world's strongest man, Mark Henry.
Well, we've talked about the size and the strength of that demonic structure, the Elimination Chamber. What about Mark Henry getting in and winning that Elimination Chamber match?
You think one of those Lexan pods would be able to contain Mark Henry? He might not be able to fit in it. Nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen, you saw the confrontation moments ago between Randy Orton and Ted DiBiase. Mr. DiBiase better be able to refocus quickly, because he's going one-on-one with this man, the world's strongest man.
Weight 235 pounds, Ted DiBiase.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, so far, John Cena, Triple H, and Randy Orton have qualified here tonight. Sheamus will defend his WWE Championship inside the Elimination Chamber in 3 weeks in St. Louis, Missouri. One of these two men will join that field. So, King, if you're Ted DiBiase, despite what you're going through with Randy Orton, what type of strategy do you need to use against the world's strongest man, Mark Henry?
Well, first of all, he's got to stay focused. I mean, that little confrontation that Ted DiBiase just had with Randy Orton has got to somehow be put out of his mind. And he's got to be put on the back burner, totally focus on the world's strongest man.
And the winner of this matchup will join Randy Orton, Triple H, John Cena, and Sheamus in the Elimination Chamber match. And there's the strength of Mark Henry. 418-pounder, a mountain of a man. Part of the Royal Rumble match last night, as was Ted DiBiase. Well, you're not going to win a match that way, no. Henry.
No, nor with a headlock either. I don't know what, not everybody can come up with the proper strategy to beat Mark Henry. Not an easy man to beat.
Well, Ted DiBiase, very few times in your career do you get into a ring against a man the size of Mark Henry King. So he's got to throw you off, but there's a great counter.
Yep, there is a great counter. I mean, if you can do something to take away and sap that strength, which is, that's what Ted's trying to do there by working on that big bicep of Mark Henry's.
Oh, look at DiBiase.
Oh,
drop toe hold, and Mark Henry, over his shoulder or his skull, that bounced off the steel steps.
I think it was his arm or his shoulder.
Also, DiBiase went right after. I guess if there's one way to take away the power of the world's strongest man.
Yeah, at least the upper body strength when you work on those arms and the biceps and shoulders.
Right back to work on the injured arm again for DiBiase. See how smart DiBiase was getting back in the ring, trying maybe to perhaps get a count out there. But Henry was in quickly as well.
Well, Ted obviously being able to
cover,
focus on
hooks
business
at hand. Three trunk-like leg of Henry, who kicks out with authority. And look at the expression on DiBiase's face.
the size of Mark Henry's arms, would you?
I find this interesting.
And the legs and the calves. Those aren't calves. Those are steers.
Many people that take on Mark Henry try to work on Mark Henry's legs, cut him down to size, but DiBiase working on the arm.
Well, I think DiBiase got that, I don't know if it was necessarily a lucky break, but I think he sensed that he slowed Henry down when that arm went into that steel ring post in the bicep.
And DiBiase counters there, again working on the injured left arm of Henry. DiBiase explodes out of the corner and runs into a clothesline.
Mark Henry just still so much strength. He's able to almost just swat Ted DiBiase away at will. Uh-oh. Foot in the face. That'll slow the world's strongest man down a little bit. You see Mark still shaking that arm.
Look at DiBiase caught in midair.
There's the strength we talk about.
Henry back to work. On the injured arm, what would it mean for Mark Henry to win this matchup and get in the Elimination Chamber as DiBiase tries to go for Dream Streets and Mark Henry counters?
Well, if Mark Henry wins this match and gets into that Elimination Chamber match, it's going to mean trouble for the other opponents in that Elimination
but
Chamber.
But DiBiase hell-bent on not allowing that to happen. Hooks the big leg again to Mark Henry. Jones got it, got him! DiBiase got him!
Whoa! The winner of the shock!
DiBiase. So for the first time in his career, Ted DiBiase will appear in Elimination Chamber matchup in 3 weeks with the WWE Championship on the line. What a win for DiBiase.
You're right. It puts him right into that Elimination Chamber match, and one of his opponents is going to be Randy Orton.
Look at
this. A shocking ending. Man, this is amazing. Ted DiBiase continued to work on the shoulders and the arms of the world's strongest man, and it paid off.
DiBiase heads to the Elimination Chamber as we check out who is already qualified tonight. Sheamus, of course, will defend the WWE Championship.
Sheamus is in, of course, defending the title, but now we have Ted DiBiase, Randy Orton, Jhn Cena, and The Game. Wow.
DiBiase successful, and only one spot remains. Who will be the final participant in the Elimination Chamber matchup? Well, we're going to find out in just a little bit. On your left-hand side of your screen, the world's largest athlete, The Big Show. He goes one-on-one with Kofi Kingston in the final qualifying matchup here tonight. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is with sad hearts that we must report to you tonight on the passing of a WWE Hall of Famer and a wonderful member of the WWE family, Jack Briscoe. He was 68 years old.
And Jack Briscoe was a world champion in the 70s and a great athlete and an even greater gentleman. I mean, it was an honor to know Jack Briscoe and to work with him.
It is our pleasure to take a look back at the wonderful life and career of Jack Briscoe.